Teardrop squat.
That's, I actually like that.
Teardrop squat. She'll, there we go.
It'll make you cry if you're not used to it. Right.
Oh, it's the teardrop squat. Mark just made one of the greatest knee breakthroughs. I'm going to show you why. By using a band about, you know, neck height, as if you were setting up to do squats or something like that, and holding wider than even the person with the weakest knees or the heaviest person can get in and get a full knee bend. And by full, I mean my glute is going to my heel. So my torso is going to be vertical. I'm not opening up like that, like in a sissy squat, which leaves more room, nor am I doing a normal squat, which still leaves some room. So this is the most knee bend, and I can pull myself up. And as I get stronger, I can hold closer into the band. Notice how there's more give. So this is actually harder. Whereas here I could pull like almost exclusively with my upper body. But even this is allowing me to engage. And when you're at 140 degrees, so like this is 90 degrees. As you go below 90, the deeper you go, the more you do prefer the VMO. The VMO, proven to reduce knee pain. You also get even more stretch of the quad and patellar tendons. You can actually grow those tendons and ligaments more. So by doing this, I would say scientifically, you can get the most development of your VMO, the most growth of the tendon and ligaments. Now you could over time even switch, I would still balance there, but then you can get into that without any assistance. So I can do this to be like freaky, but as we've already seen in the gym here, even the worst knees in the gym can start doing that, and for ultra high reps. So it's not something I would think of for lower reps, ultra high reps. Mark changed the game with this simplest, most transformative knee exercise, in my opinion.
Very simple. Part of the reason why I came up with it was just, I've been trying bend stuff for a while. I've been doing the ass to grass split squats and stuff like that, but I needed to figure out a way to reduce my own body weight. So for those of you that have spent a lot of time with hypertrophy, trying to get yourself bigger, and you're now 200 plus pounds, 230 pounds, 250 pounds, whatever your weight is, we can dissipate a lot of that into this band by utilizing this. So one of the things I did, I was like, let me put my armpits over top of the band and let me get in here and let me see if I can move around in some weird position that Ben moves in from like Rogue Fitness or Elite Fitness, right? We put it on the J-pegs. You want to make sure it's safe. We want to make sure that it doesn't come slinging out this way, right? You can also go facing inward, so I could go this way if I wanted to as well, but just for demonstration purposes, a little less crap in the way. Putting my armpits here, and now I can start to get into some positions that are a little bit similar to Ben. If I don't have this band to pull up 10% of my body weight, 20% of my body weight, I can't get into this stretch now. So now I can start to look as weird as him, not as nerdy or dorky, like no one can match him on that, but I can get in these positions, right? And then when it comes to that squat that we were doing, that's something that Ben and I and Nsima were working on yesterday. And I can have my feet pointed out just a bit, give me a little freedom in the hips, and I can try to squat down with my back completely straight up and down, and I can really dump into the knees. If I'm gonna try to dump into my knees, like I haven't really done a lot of stuff in here yet today, my brain is like, dude, not a good idea. I can do it, I can force myself to do it, but it just, like coming out of that just feels like sketch. So I don't wanna mess with that, so I'm gonna go here. I'd rather have it not feel sketchy. And so now I can go here, and then I can start to try to get a real upright back. Nice. I can force the knees out, and then I can start to figure out, okay, maybe I don't need that much from here.
Wow.
But as I'm taking some off, I'm also feeling a little bit in the knees. So I'm not gonna do anything that's gonna be too stressful or too harmful until I feel ready for it. And I'm trying to get my butt to sink down to my heels, but it just doesn't quite go there yet.
This, look at the angle from the hip to the ankle. So that's like a ton. You have to be getting really close to like 140 degrees of bend there.
I think we can all agree there's a lot of different levels of strength. There's a lot of different types of strength. I built up strength for powerlifting, bench press, squat, deadlift. I wouldn't be strong on gymnastics rings, right? You guys know that. I wouldn't be strong doing gymnastics moves and things like that. So in this position, my skill level at this position is next to nothing because I haven't spent time here. So why would I want to do it like this when that kind of hurts? That's a little too stressful for me at the moment. Instead, I'm going to go boop right here, and now I can go.
Nice.
And now I can do maybe 25 to 50 reps for 3-4 sets twice a week, maybe about 100 reps total twice a week, and really build the crap out of these VMOs and start to build up those Tom Platz-like quads.
Yeah, and we're pulling from Louis Simmons on getting the blood flow to the tendons. So it's not that you couldn't add weight or something, but we're saying based on the purpose of what we're trying to get out of it, yeah, we've settled on 3-4 sets, 20 to 25 to 50, 1 to 2 times a week. I'll be doing it Wednesdays and Saturdays in my program. Yeah. Dude, that was amazing.
That gets into your soul. How'd you feel after you did them yesterday?
Yeah, one thing I want to add is like, over the years, like I've trained a lot of legs. I played a lot of soccer, so my legs are my strongest body part personally. But this reason why this, I think this is so amazing is because it's unloaded and I don't need load. I only did like maybe 2 sets or 3 sets of 25 yesterday. And it's the first time in ever that I've ever felt any type of deep soreness in the upper part of my VMO. Like I felt this whole thing was firing up, but I was feeling this massively yesterday. And it's so sick.
Dude,
because
Mike cramped up in the middle of the night.
I was eating and I literally got up and I was walking like this to get electrolytes because my VMOs were on fire. And I've literally never felt that through my whole training career, doing leg extensions, hack squats, all
and,
that shit.
And in the textbooks, it says you can't prefer the VMO, but it only tested to 90 degrees. Ah. And a later study came out showing that when you go to 140 degrees, it's almost exclusively the VMO getting out. So this scientifically, I'd have to say it's the greatest knee exercise, but we all felt that. This is not a squat. It's not a glute. Right. This is a knee exercise.
Yeah.
But if he could, I mean, his legs, if he can get a workout out of it, and we have on camera Russell.
Yeah, absolutely.
Russell getting a workout on it, who hasn't been able to do any deep bending. Boom, that regression got him into it instantly. He did his backward work, warmed up. Boom, got in. Mm-hmm. Amazing.
Yeah, and the cool thing is that you're like, it's definitely a knee exercise, but I wasn't feeling any type of like knee soreness or anything yesterday. It was literally just like all right there in the VMO, and I can rep this out, and then after a while, I can just use this, like you mentioned, just
amazing.
Use this as a guide so that, yeah, I'm like, I'm feeling it right now. It's insane how much of this is activating as I do it. It's just, this is gonna be a staple now for me.
Yeah, and I mean, so the thing with the VMO, it's not just like, oh, having a larger VMO makes no knee pain. It's the proportion. Mm-hmm. So proportionally more VMO equals less knee pain.
Yep.
And now we have a way of getting into that without pain. And the trick is that if you walk up and you're cold and you do this with no assistance and you feel pain, the pain means we caused some degree of trauma there. Mm. You see what I mean? Now you have to recover from that trauma. So really you're looking at where do you have no pain and then do a ton of reps. So very similar to the concept of the sled,
right.
But the sled doesn't allow us to get what? The most transformative part, this. The sled warms us up into this.
Yeah.
Backward sled, to then forward sled, to then, honestly, we need a great name for this, but so even for someone like me who's done every knee exercise, or so I thought.
How about Uber squats?
Uber squats.
Well, basically something to indicate that it's not just, this is not just a full squat, it's actually the fullest knee bend.
Right.
Like we're trying to get the most, and for everyone that'll start out different, but the point is we're trying to bend our knee the most we can.
Teardrop squat?
I actually like that.
Teardrop squat,
she'll
there we go.
It'll make you cry if you're not used to it.
Oh, it's the teardrop squat.
There we go.
I like good that. Shit.
Show them the teardrop so the people know what we're talking about. Okay, so it looks, let's put the emoji on
are
there.
Are people's legs supposed
this
to look
is,
like
this
that?
Is actually, this is actually a great
yeah,
thumbnail.
Yeah, look at the lump you got right there, it's sick.
Yeah, lumpy. And see, I've got all this junk here, but I'm protected, I got the extra protection. Yep. And I don't
do
even
see,
have.
You see this in Nsima, look. This
yeah,
lump.
It just like pops out.
Yeah. Both sides, pretty good too.
Yeah.
One thing I wanted to add is that depending on your level, like if you really stink at this kind of stuff, you're not good at that, you can put this up higher. You can also use thicker bands. So you could use a thicker band. You could use multiple bands if you wanted to. And then also, as we were pointing out earlier, our buddy Russell, he was grabbing out here because that turns this band a little bit more into a rope. And then you can figure out whatever level you want to do on here. I can have my lats engaged on here and there's no tension in my knees right now at all, like nothing uncomfortable. And if I wanted to have less, I would bring it in here like this. and I would go like, yay. Russell, buddy, pop on in here, buddy. Show these guys what's up.
Hi.
You get second bed?
Here's our boy, Russell. He's been training with us for a while.
And Russell
he went
came
to Ben's seminar.
This. I just do it.
Russell came up with the width. I got to add this band for you.
I do it different, though. I go on the inside.
Yep.
Because if I fall backwards that way, this won't catch it.
Yep.
Because I lean back to sort of stabilize.
There you go.
And then I...
You guys see what he's talking about? He doesn't want this to pop out this way.
That way
so it has no way of falling.
If I fall forward, I'll catch myself.
Because he has to squat slightly differently than what we're doing. Do whatever's like super, super comfortable.
Yeah, this is super comfortable.
Good. Stay there.
Nice.
Maybe try about 5 more reps like that. And then when you feel comfortable enough, see if you can go a little lower for a couple reps.
Sure.
Nice. You can already see that. Keep going. You can already see that bend taking place. And let him, like, this is how we chill out. Like, look, cameraman's on it right now. Look at his feet. Look at his feet. So we're most of us are not going to be like this. Most of us are going to be more comfortable like this. And that's going to allow us to get deeper. So he's already getting.
You see how he did that bounce, too? That's natural. That's
he's
good.
Looking right. Smooth.
Yeah.
Well, I'm cutting, you know, being a big boy, I got a lot of ham on the bone.
Yeah.
And I feel it push into my knee when I get all the way down.
Yep.
Maybe it's the calf.
Is there some pain? Is there some pain there too?
If I go too far.
Okay.
If I go too far, yeah.
And if there's pain, anybody watching, if there's a pain on a scale of 1 to 10 and it's anything above a 3,
and discontinue. You probably can find a 0.
Yeah.
You probably can find that 0 for
I
you.
Agree. I agree with that.
Put in the work. Now over time, that's going to make you more bulletproof.
Right.
Now it's going to be easier to go sweat on the sleds. And then it's making an investment.
Yep.
This isn't a gamble. This is trying to make an investment.
Right.
You want to pop out some more? I see you're getting a sweat going. That's good.
Yes.
I mean,
it's true.
Yeah, keep rolling.
You're getting
nature. And then go here, hit these. All right.
Oh, he's going to go for it. Look at that.
There you go.
Amazing.
Well, now his hands are close.
And then because I can pull back.
That's ridiculously impressive. Wow.
There.
Oh. Good job.
Good work.
I'm going to throw Alyssa in there.
Good work.
I'm going to throw someone who's never even done this exercise. Come on in. Wow. Come on in.
Uh-oh.
So, why don't you, that'll work. Why don't you hold kind of wide on there?
Yeah.
Yep. Stand up to it. Heels close
together. Who is this person? We're taking people off the street and helping them? What's going
on? I just found a hottie out there.
Looking.
Good. I got
You're
lucky.
You're like, yo.
Like this?
Look at that. Wow. And then up. Now, why is this important for her? Alyssa's 4 months pregnant. She's not going to be able to do all my crazy exercises as the time goes on. But you're actually supposed to keep squatting. It's one of the best things you can do throughout pregnancy, leading up to
keep
delivering
your strength,
the baby.
Right,
and this so she can scale. So you can scale it.
It's amazing.
And now start pumping. Start pumping.
Fast, Facer?
Well, whatever feels good. Look at this. Incredible. I think I'm the only person who can check this, but let's see. Can you touch my finger? Oh, she got it.
Did I do it?
Yeah. I won't check that on you guys.
Dropping it like it's hot.
Yeah.
How do you feel about pumping in that range?
I kind of like staying down there. Like, I don't like really locking out at the top. Well, coming up a little bit more. Yeah, like right there. Exactly.
Whew.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. She's getting it. But look, and she was, and now I wouldn't advise doing it cold. I would advise do your backward sled, do your forward sled. That's how I do leg days. Look, I'm Mr. Knee Guy. I don't even mess with it. What's the first thing I did? Came in, did my backward, did my forward, then I came here. But I just wanted to show how scalable this is. That even for her, cold, she could walk right in and do it, pregnant. Mark made the greatest knee breakthrough of 2022.
Seriously,
didn't come from me, came from Mark.
Pretty good stuff. That's a great way to get into the knee. And as I always say, strength is never weakness, right? Weakness is never strength. You're only as strong as your weakest link. So if your knee is holding your back, your hip is holding you back, you got some sort of joint issue with your elbow or shoulder, you're only going to be as strong as those weak links. You got to figure out ways to tap into them. So we're always looking for new exercises. Always, always, always. Strength is never weakness. Weakness is never strength. Catch you guys later.